Is it a professional? That's all we need. That's all we need. I know we're doing it right.
Are we rolling? Good morning, everybody. How are we doing? Okay, another one of our questions we get asked all the time. How do you colour sand and buff? What products do you use? Blah, 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 blah. So, I thought we'd do a proper detailed video on how we do it, what we do, blah, 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 blah. So, what I have done is we've done this 350 and I deliberately turned my pressure down on the gun because I knew I wanted to do a video anyway, and got sprayed really close with a clear so we'd get like a peel, and then I can show you guys what we do to get rid of it. So this, we've gone straight to this. Let me see if I can just clean it up a minute and I'll show you some peel. Whatnot. Okay, now this obviously was done in liquid glass. We did it last week. And obviously it's the best clear coat on the market. We've proven that time and time again. Okay, so peel. Okay, sometimes you need peel because, I mean, a lot of these cars nowadays, a lot of these OEM cars come out and look crap. But as a painter, it is your task, your skill, to match the previous finish of the vehicle. On newer cars anyway. Like this thing, we kind of, we've done what we've had to do, because we're gonna, as the, like, to help them out so it doesn't look funny, we're gonna flatten the rest of the car, which the previous numbnuts didn't do. So, as you can see, I mean, this is a fiberglass panel anyway. But you can see, peel in this? I know I sort of tried to get peel. There you go, you'll get that down there. See it? To match the rest of the peel on the doors and everything else. So, all right, you got it?
Yeah.
Cool. Now you can see, my weapons of choice. When I'm colour sanding and buffing, I like to do quite a coarse grit first off. The reason being is with stuff like this, you're refining the surface, okay? If you were just using it to get crap and everything up the paint, you'd probably go straight to a 2000 to denib and polish. We go in something like this by hand, we'll go straight in with 1200 grit. The first initial cut is a sharp, short grit that slides straight across, taking it down. If you went to a 1500 or a 2000, you're not really going to be taking down the roughness, you're just kind of fumbling over it. No different with your primers. If you look down the side of a freshly painted car and you see that it does waves, that's because the primer wasn't flattened properly and the clear coat wasn't flattened properly. So we're using the 3M paper, the 3M soft block. I mean, the 1500s are the new Velcro ones, which are unbelievable. They are so good. And obviously, we're in the middle of changing all our papers over. Colour sanding, pressure bottle. Do not use a bucket, especially with soap in it. That's the most retarded thing I've ever heard. You're gonna sand whatever's on the car back into the bucket, and then back from the bucket back onto the car again. Not only that, the key to a good colour sand is keeping your material clean, so keeping your paper clean. Pressure bottle does all of that. So, very quick, very simple. I don't know, let's just do this bit. Right. So, down like that. And then, remember, you've got to do crisscross patterns. And I can't use a hard block because there's too many lines, there's too many curves. So we go straight in with a soft block. Crisscross angles. And that enables that also you will get a flat panel, all right? Nice and quick, nice and simple, nice and easy. Clean your pads off, see? Clean your wing off or whatever it is you're doing. And voila, that's what you end up with compared to what's next door there. So, like I said, crisscross patterns. If you've got a big panel without as many curves, like say that door for instance, or a flat bonnet, then yes, go for a hard block. We obviously don't have that here in this area for the minute, so we're using the 3M soft block, the Velcro block, which we'll use for the 1500 on all this area here. And like I said, I'm using that soft squidgy block so I can get all the little contours. So, and I, like I said, I like doing this by hand. Yeah, you can use your DA. I'll use the DA for 2000 because 2000 doesn't really cut like that. Whereas, you know, 1500 and whatnot does. So that's why you still got to remember like your crisscross patterns and everything. So, and just like I said, just use a pressure bottle. Look how clean it keeps it. So, you know, and you just want to go back and forth, take your time. It is our graft, but the results are phenomenal. Right. Oh, fucking hell. Okay. So we've done 1200 by hand, we've done 1500 by hand. So that's the cutting side of the clear coat done. So now we're moving on to polishing and refining. So we've got our marker, colourSand and DA, 2000 grit on this bad boy. By the way, one 1500 of that 3M Velcro did the whole fucking car, didn't it?
We had to
work, yeah, we had to work a little bit harder towards the end, but it's still done it. Okay, so this is the difference between like 1500 and 2000. You can start seeing that this starts being refined now. You know what I mean? That just, I mean, a bit of water and stuff, that looks epic. I mean, this is 1500 here. And you can, I mean, you can see the friggin' difference straight away. You see, so a lot of paces will finish at 1500 and cut them buff, but we don't. We like to go all the way up to 3000, and it's really simple. Again, you're keeping in your crisscross pattern. Don't saturate in water because, I mean, you don't need to. So. Add a bit of pressure because obviously it's 2000 grit. How we do it. Other people do it different ways. We do it this way. This is what works for us. Alright. Tight, tight overlaps. So, all the way down. Done all the hard work with the 12 and the 15. So again, making sure you're keeping everything nice and clean. So, and then just rinse off. And you'll notice how the water flows so much better when you start getting higher up in your grits. So, and obviously, you then get a feel for kind of that's what the panel's going to look like when it's buffed. Okay, I mean, just prepping this a minute at 3000. massive crack in that bonnet. I've just been pressing like fuck on it.
So it's right up along there.
Hey?
So it was up along there somewhere.
No, and it was in the middle, right there.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're at 3,000. And we use trizac. Well, we use all 3M stuff, to be honest, when it comes to abrasives. So what I wanted to show you was the difference between buffing at 1500 and buffing at 3000. So over here, these two panels are dry, right? And they kind of, you know, they look similar-ish, right? You would agree. This 3000, that's 1500, I think. But look what happens when you add water. So, you know, that still looks good, yeah? Still looks right, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, but look at what happens when you add water to 3000. See how much clearer that is. See the difference? Yeah. And that's why you're going to
my eyes. Ah!
Oh! So what happens when you spend all day fucking colourSand here? Oh, okay. Remember, people, we got a shout because we got cold, so we decided to turn our booth on and warm the place up. Wondering why this wall panel looks absolutely epic, that's because that's at 3000. This is at 2000. We didn't paint this, so we're trying to just flatten it off so it kind of looks the same, which it won't look miles off. But anyway, we're at we're doing well, man. We're doing well. So little misting again, make sure your 3000's nice and clean. And you want to put pressure on, you know, you're at 3000, you know, it's a very, very fine brick paper. So, put some pressure on, really work it in. Yeah, we've shown you the difference. Why we like to go to 3000, us personally. When you've got a tool like this, it doesn't take long. But again, if you don't have it, doesn't matter. You can do this at home, wherever you want. You know, we're not a fast, fit insurance place at all. For us it is, you know, we do like to try and take as much time as we can with balancing the customer's budget and giving them the results they want. Anyhow, we don't succeed all the time, we're only fucking human. You know, we have an off day just like you guys have an off day, so you know, just how you deal with it. So as you can see, right, pretty much I like to go across in 3000 like this, right, back up again. Alright, that way you don't miss anything. At all. Alright, pump your bottle even. Keep it nice and clean. The trick is to keep your disc clean. You know what I mean? Keep your disc nice and clean. Alright? And then wash it all off. You know, you want to keep rinsing your panels off completely. That way you don't have any crappy chalky shit afterwards. And then you can really see how it's going to look when it's polished. So, and you saw how quick that was. I mean, this DA I think is nearly 300 quid. I think it will take. It's down to the orbit. This has got like a 2mm orbit, whereas normal DAs have got a 5. But I do want a new one. But this Barker one's lasted me 4 years. Got pressure regulator on it as well because I don't want to go above 40 psi. So but anyway, yeah, we're at that at the moment. Oh fuck, we've got to get this rubbish cleared out as well. So with 3,000 grit, well, 2,000 and 3,000, you can pretty much go over all your edges. You don't need to worry too much about it. It's only with like 1,500 that you will. I mean, 2,000 will burn, but just don't be an asshole. So the good thing about those quartz compounds that we're going to get out in a minute as well is you can go over edges with those. They're a water-based compound. They don't burn. Quickly 3,000 that front bumper, we'll grab the compound and then we'll show you sort of where we're going to go compound wise, how to start it, what pads are for what and whatnot, and then you can go ahead, jump on SprayGunsDirect, buy the quartz compound and know exactly what you're getting. I'm going down some stairs. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, if you have successfully flattened your vehicle to 3,000 grit, have a sheen much like a satin finish. Voila, that's 3,000 grit. All right, so it's all uniform and whatnot, or as uniform as you can get it. Remember, we let our paper soak for 20 minutes in warm water, 1200 and 1500 block by hand, and then we jump straight up to 2000 with trizac. 3,000 on the DA and worked it like that. What's that song? If you like it, maybe work it. Flip down, flip it, and reverse it.
You sure to my dip with you, yeah? You sure to my dip with you,
yeah? I hope your editing's good.
No, fuck it, I ain't editing this shit. This is going on raw. So, I don't have the blue one because Jay from JR Motors still fucking has it. Wanker. The little wanker. So we are going to use this little bugger more than likely on some of the bumper areas and whatnot. We're still going to start with the red, with the 1200 from Quartz. We're still going to start with that one. Now, there's a few heads that you can use with this compound depending on when you finish. If you are finished at 1500 grit and you just want to buff out, right, then you would grab this motherfucker, this white one. I don't use this. This is fucking way too hard. That is a stiff ass like pad. These are brilliant as well, by the way, like a memory foam. And I've seen how they're made, and it's quite cool. So, you just put that straight on your backing plate. But I don't. I like to use the foam backing plate here. I've also got an additional one as well, just in case. So, but that is a very, I mean, that's a very stiff pad, very stiff, and I don't use that one. You've also got a slightly smaller one, lighter, which I don't use, and you've got a green one. Again, I've not used the green one yet. It's a bit hard to figure out where the application would be, but there's a lot, difference between this one and the white one, obviously this is a little bit softer, and it's got more air bubbles in it, air pockets, so it cools down a lot quicker. So the main two that I will use are the brown, which is there, and the yellow. Now these are the two that I will use. Now I can jump straight to the yellow and that'll be fine. The brown one is a little bit harder. You know, I just like using this one. But I think for this purpose, I will use, you've got two waffle pads. You use the black with the blue, all right, as a final finish. And you use the blue with the yellow. You can also use the red with the blue. All right, just depending on what you like, but they will give you, they'll all give you the same sort of results. So obviously with the waffle, you know, more air, gets rid of your swirls and whatnot, and I just love them. So, and like I said, this is the inspection spray stuff as well. You spray it on, it lifts anything up, you wipe it off with a clean microfiber, you get a true shine. So we are going to get our shit ready and we'll use this one and whatnot and the yellow pad and we'll get cracking. So as you can see, I'm wearing my very fashionable
shoe, man.
Yeah, but this protects me and the car, and you can put your polish compounds in these little pouches. So jump on the Dickies website, go to the streetwear section and you'll find these aprons along with all the other stuff that we use. Right, Sealy lightweight, which isn't light enough for me, unfortunately. I now, after a couple of years of using it, as you know, my hands have got a lot worse, so I struggle holding this thing at the moment. So that's why we're going down the detailing route with our compounding and stuff. So right, I'm using yellow, centered on the squishy. Right, I just like to mist on some hot water, warm water, hot water, whatever. All right. Soften that fucker up. Alright, make sure there's no shit or anything on it, see? Alright, put it around the lead, around the back of your neck, like so. So you don't want it fucking dragging across the body. Obviously, shake the compound. Alright, now, the difference with this and all the other crap, 3M stuff contains fillers, which is no fucking, it's ideal. People use what they're used to and what they like. I don't like 3M, it contains fillers and gives us a false reading of the shine of the panel. Freckler stuff burns up on you, it's very messy and greasy and whatnot. This stuff isn't, so hence why we use it. So what I like to do, and I'm not dissing the other products, if you guys get on with those, brilliant. Just, you know what I mean, know what you're using. So, what I like to do, 4 dollops, like so, all right, and then, oh, this is set on E, it's all variable speed and the usual shite, all right, so, all right, that's what I like to do, right, so you're kind of priming the pad, right, and then just on a low speed, work it in. Like I said, this is just the way I do it. You guys might have other ways or whatnot. Okay, with edges, there's probably loads of other, but you can see how the compound turns watery. See how cool that is? When you get to edges, obviously you go with the way that flips off the edge, not onto the edge. Doesn't really matter with the quartz stuff, but get into the habit of it, all right? So, start picking up your speed. I like to keep it as flat as I can, really. Alright. Off your edges, pick up the speed. And you push down to cut. And you release, like lift up, when you want to bump. And it does get messy, that's the joy of compounding. No, that'll be some detailers that are yelling at me. You don't do it that way, you do it this way. I know. Starts coming back. Nice and easy like that. Alright. Pretty much as simple as that. Let me just show you on this one doodah there. I'll get this spray in a minute. It's ridiculous. I don't think I've got any decent fucking microfibers if I'm honest. Okay, so a bit of spray. Green microfiber, is it clean? I don't know if I'm fucking blue. Probably not. Alright, just wipe it off. Also, you can see a little bit of compound, I think, is flicked up onto here. Right, and usually, that's a pain in the ass. Am I right or am I fucking, or am I right?
Nightmare on all rubbers.
Yep.
But, there's always a but. Not the quartz.
Not the quartz, my friend. All right. There we go.
That right there is why I love that stuff.
Comes off rubbers, like no issues at all. So I need to get a different microfiber because this one's shite. But looks alright. But how many swirls does that fucking just put in it? You get the general idea. Woo, bit of dust. I mean, you can see the metallics in there, right? Like I said, we'd compound all of this, put the spray on and whatnot, wipe everything down, then I would get one of the other pads, the waffle pads, and then just go over it again to buff it up. But like I said, it's so fucking, you know what I mean, it is so easy to use. It's unbelievable. Even a monkey like me can use it. I mean, come on. But do you notice we're not putting any water actually down? We're not trying to soften anything. We're not trying to dilute anything. You know what I mean? We're just letting the product do its thing. So what I do like to do, in all honesty, is when I've made a few passes, I'll get some warm water again, and I'll clean the pad. So I find that helps as well. Keep your shit all nice and clean. But then we've been saying that sort of the whole way along, really, haven't we?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Keep your shit clean. So, woo! That splashed up a little bit on us. Oh yeah, by the way, when you're cutting, I like to keep flat or go that way. And when you're buffing off, go that way. I just found that that's easier and that cleans the compound. Have you seen this black? We haven't even wiped the shit off yet. Look at the metallics in there. Get over this area here, like. Woo! That looks fucking so nice, doesn't it?
do see even far away.
So we've got to finish. But you'll notice, like I said, like the compound, it's not greasy. It's not, it doesn't burn on you. You don't have to dilute it. Do you know what I mean? It spins itself down to the point where, you know, you can wipe this off. And like most, let it dry a little bit and buff the shit off, because it does look incredible. Oh, we're shouting about quartz because we get it free, or because we help Chris, or whatever it is. No, that's not the case. And if you think that, you're a fucking idiot. When the compounds came out, Chris, something that, I mean, we've been with Chris for nearly, I've been with Chris 4.5 years. And I've always said I wanted a line of products that I could use custom in the custom world that are the best products on the market, hands down. Now, we've got that. We've got that now. Now, like I said, the quartz compounds, I love. I've still got other compounds up on top of the cupboard that I just don't use anymore, because they are just, they're not superior enough. They don't do what I want them to do. So I use this stuff. Now, there are other things, of course, like there's masking tape and there's sanding discs and colour sanding discs and whatnot. I don't like them. Chris sent them down for me to try. I'm like, he's like, they're cheaper. I'm like, yeah, but I don't care. They don't cut the way I want. They don't, like the masking tape, I don't like the masking tape. I use 3M blue. My abrasives are 3M, either gold, purple, or, you know, we use the trizac stuff. So no, just because it's whatever, we don't shout about everything. We shout about what is good, what can be used, and what is beneficial to either to do here in a fully equipped garage, or for you guys to give it a go at home. So like I said, that's what it's all about, yeah? You know what I mean? Sharing the love. So, that's just my take on it anyway.
We won't big up product if it ain't good enough.
If it ain't any good, what's the fucking point?
Yeah.
You know, we're very lucky. A lot of people watch what we do and take it to heart. So I want to make sure anything we shout about, it does what it says it's going to do. And we can show that. You know, so, but like I said, I'm gonna right. So as you can see, we finished compounding. We had loads of, we had polish over the top of it, and we just moist up the pad, ran over it, and obviously just poured it up lovely. But what we were saying about how you've got, like, you know, dry polish and whatnot, we just use warm water in all the nooks and crannies and stuff. Like the rubbers are the big thing with compounding, aren't they? You know what I mean? That's what gets fucking, that's what gets clogged up.
Yeah. So it takes fucking days and days to get that shit off. But this.
There you go.
Done.
You know what I mean? So, I've got the rubbers all down the inside of the windscreen. Yeah, luckily. Done. You know what I mean? This is the beauty of this compound. The clean up, you know what I mean? It's unreal. There you go, this is just water.
Someone finds another compound that does that.
I mean, no, there is probably compound out there that does, right? But we are, in the body shop industry, you only kind of really use a few. Do you know what I mean? You've got your Freckler, your 3M, and you. And obviously now your Quartz.
Where's my squeegee?
You know, and we like to do stuff that's different, so that's why, you know, and the quartz is sort of our own thing, you know, we work with Chris a lot of the time to give products for custom as well, so
check that out.
Windows clean, rubbers clean. Is there any other way around here that we can just demonstrate what happens? It's like dry compound. Back window, I suppose. Would this work?
Yeah.
All right. Oh god, that doesn't look like it's done anything, does it?
No.
There you go. That's a rubber. This is a rubber down here, obviously. And whatnot. And that's the beauty of this compound. This is what I'm saying. It cuts effortlessly. You know, it's absolutely freaking amazing. And for rubber's right here. Okay, dry compound. This is dry. My hands are wet, but this is dry. You know, so right in the nooks and crannies.
Cloth and fucking zombies.
Scott.Mills at bbc.co.uk. It kind of makes the show.
Yeah, absolutely.
One of those people that sent me an email over the last couple of days is Jenny. Hi, Jenny.
Not like I'm pressing hard or anything on it either.
You're right.
So, there we go.
What have you got for us
and now?
Well,
no compound. Over any of the others. At all.
You've got to be a really big fan to do the midnight one, I think. My mate Betsy.
There you go. We left the window open stupidly. Put a compound on the door cards.
What do you say?
I did. Right. Either dampen that down or dampen that down. Just a little bit. I mean, we're going to clean all this anyway. Okay. There we go.
This makes polishing in general.
Here.
So much
look at these rubbers here. Notorious for it. There you go. And this is hot water, warm water, whatever, so it dries instantly. There you go, done. So, I don't think we need to prove how good these compounds are anymore, do we?
Nah, everything's covered.
We will do a proper on all three. This is just a general overview on how we here colour sand and buff from start to finish. If you guys want to see a more in-depth view, or you want us to say, hey, listen, can you scratch up a panel with 1500, or can you scratch up from 2000, and let us know. We will do a proper segment of colour sanding right the way. I think we've got red metal flake panels to colour sand, so we'll do a segment for colour sanding those from start to finish, and then we'll break it into another segment on compounding, because we'll have to use a little mini compounder mop on that. So is there anything we need to add?
Nope.
Okay.
I think that's it.
Well, there you go. So, hopefully you found this this tip helpful, even if it is a 15-20 minute long video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and of course, on YouTube.
Buy some quartz.
Buy some quartz.